everyone, welcome back. Earlier, you learned about air.
Let's understand what is water and its importance.
First and foremost, where do we use water? We use it in quenching thirst, bathing, washing, and many other things. Do you know how much water exists on Earth? The blue colored part you can see is water, and it is about 75%. Therefore, 75% of total surface of Earth is covered by water. Well friends, where does water come from at your house? From the tap? But where does the water in the tap come from? Think. Water is drawn into the tap from the nearby rivers, lakes, and groundwater. So, these are the sources of water.
Can you think of other sources of water? They are rain, ocean, sea, and mountains covered with snow.
Friends, have you ever been to the beach? Yes, we all have been to the beach and even tasted water. What does seawater taste like? Saline. But have you ever thought why? This is because the rain dissolves the salt from the rocks through the runoff and mixes with the sea. So friends, got an idea why the seawater is salty? Friends, it is well known that humans, animals, and plants all need water. Let us know how water is important for us. Water is essential for all living organisms as it is required for all cellular reactions occurring inside the body.
We see very few plants and animals in the desert. Have you ever thought why?
Because sources of water like lakes, rivers, etc. are not found in the desert. So now you can understand how water is important. Well, water decides the biodiversity of a region. But what will happen if water gets polluted? Lots of problems are being faced by humans due to water pollution, like typhoid fever, cholera, etc. In fact, aquatic animals are also being affected due to water pollution. Do you know what is the main cause of water pollution? Let's understand. Factories produce lots of harmful chemicals. These harmful chemicals are dumped in a nearby reservoir, which pollutes the water. Do you know where the wastewater from the sink, bathtub, shower, toilet goes? The wastewater is dumped in the nearby reservoir, which also makes the water in the reservoir dirty. Not only this, the use of pesticides and fertilizers by the farmers also pollutes the water. Friends, what if useful substances like oxygen are removed from water? Just think. Aquatic plants and animals will not get oxygen and they will die in the end.
So any change that results in lack of oxygen in the water are considered water pollution.
You will be surprised to know that a sudden change in the temperature of water also causes water pollution. But how? Let's see.
Aquatic animals are used to a certain range of temperature inside the water. Anything that alters or changes the temperature of water also affects the aquatic plants and animals, which again leads to water pollution. For example, factories like thermal power plants take cold water from the reservoir and pour hot water into the same reservoir.
This increases the water temperature, which greatly affects the life of aquatic plants and animals. Can water pollution be prevented? Yes, it can be prevented. Let us see how. Water pollution can be prevented by using manure instead of fertilizers, by not throwing garbage into the water, by not throwing chemicals into the sink or toilet. So what did we learn in this video? Water, importance of water, water pollution, causes and consequences of water pollution. And in the next video, we will learn about soil and soil erosion.